In today's lecture, we are going to study a very famous story, Three Questions, written by Leo Tolstoy. Certain people believe that the real purpose of life is eat, drink, and remarry. But the Holy Scripts believe that the real purpose of life is salvation. In this present story, Leo Tolstoy tells about the real purpose of life. Leo Tolstoy was a famous Russian writer, novelist, and philosopher, and you can say that he was a spiritual thinker. He was born on 9th September 1828. He passed away on 20th November 1910. There are famous books written by this great author of all the time. The famous book War and Peace that came into 1867. Mahatma Gandhi was greatly impressed by this book. Another great book is Anna Karenina that was published in 1877. The third one is Resurrection that was published in 1899. There's some famous quotation from the mouth of Leo Tolstoy. I quote, "The most powerful warriors are patience and time," unquote. He says that in the battle of life, in the journey of life, in the passage of life, there are two important persons. The one is patience and the other is time. If someone keeps patience, if he has enough time, he can reach to the goal, he can get the benefits of life. Next one is that, I quote, "Music is the shorthand of emotions," unquote. Very beautiful quotations, that whatever emotions we have in our mind, whatever emotions we have hidden emotions in our mind, that are expressed through the music and in a very shorthand manner, in a very short manner. Now I come to the story about the writer, that he was the Russian novelist, short story writer. He was loved and respected as much for his powerful writings as for his religious and spiritual outlook. Yes, he was loved and respected for his spiritual outlook. He was born in the aristocratic family, but he lived a life of separation. All the time, he was devoted for love of God and humanity. He wrote for the love of humanity and God. His philosophy of truth, non-violence, non-resistance to evil, love of humanity impressed and influenced Mahatma Gandhi. His writings display his great moral conviction, eye for realistic details and visionary powers. He says in a book, What is Art? That in this book, he says that art is a profound analysis of the nature of art. The another book that is Confession is an autobiographical description of his spiritual crisis, in what manner he passed through the ups and downs of spiritual realization. His short stories are not only a piece of short writing, but his short stories are intentionally imaginative, dedicated in tone and convey his philosophy in a simple diction. Now I come to the story that is in our course, our Three Questions. It was written in 1903. It is one of the stories that reveals the importance of present in life. That what is the importance of present time of now in our practical life? He says that it is the now that matters in our dealings. The past is gone and the future is still hidden. See in what manner it tells the importance of the now, that now is the present time where we have the power. We have the power to do something. The past is gone that never returns, and future is hidden in the pages of life. We cannot know what is going to happen in the near future. That's why he says the most important time is the present time, where we can do something. The most important person is the one we are dealing with at the present. Yes, the question arises that who are the most important persons? And the most important persons are those with whom we are at the present time. Now, to say that the final purpose of life is to do good to our fellow beings. For this purpose, for this only purpose, we are here on this earth. The moral of the story is conveyed in a very emphatic manner. The story begins like this story. I quote, "It once occurred to a certain king that if he always knew the right time to begin everything, if he knew who are the most right people to listen to and whom to avoid, and above all, if he always knew what was the most important thing to do," unquote. Yes, the king wanted to know the answers of three questions. The first question is that, what is the most important time? The second question is that, who are the most important persons? And third important question is that, what is to do in this life? The king also announced that he would give a great reward to anyone who could teach him that what was the right time for every action, who were the most important people, and how he might know what was the most important thing to do in this practical life. These questions were raised by the king, and the questions were different. Definitely, the answers of these questions came in a different manner. Some people said that the purpose of life that to get the God. Some people say that the purpose of life in this to do something practical thing. But actually, the king could not get the satisfied answer. He was not satisfied by the answer given by the great wise persons. He came to know about a hermit. He was renowned for his wisdom. That is why the king decided to consult a hermit who was living in a jungle. The king was also aware that the hermit receives only the common people. The hermit did not receive any great personality just like the king. So the king dismounted from the horse, left the bodyguard behind, and visited the hut of the hermit in a simple clothes like a simple person. He reached to the hut of the hermit. The hermit welcomed and greeted the king, but kept on his work of digging. At the time, the hermit was digging some bags. He did not pay attention to the king. The king again approached to the hermit, and he started to know the answers of the three questions. The hermit was busy in his work. He only listened to the king. But he kept on his working, digging. He was not diverted from his work. After some time, the king offered help to the hermit, and happily the hermit allowed him for digging. Again, the king repeated his questions, but the questions were not answered. The hermit was busy. It was the practice of the hermit that he was giving the answer in his own manner, in his own way. After some time, the hermit gave a turn to the incidents, to the story, and ordered to notice a person who was coming toward the cottage. The hermit said to look at the person who was coming from the other side, and the person was coming to the hut. The king noticed that a bearded man was coming, pressing his hands towards his stomach. The blood was coming out. The person was wounded. He was stabbed by someone. That's why the blood was coming from his body. The king and the hermit unfastened the cloths, and the king bandaged the wounds of the bleeding person with his own handkerchief. The king and hermit provided help to that wounded person. The blood was coming. The king again and again removed the bandage soaking blood, washed and rebandaged the wound, he provided full help to that wounded person. The wounded person recognized the king. He was the enemy of the king. But the wounded person silently noticed the way in which the king was giving help to this wounded person. The wounded person came to the forest to finish the king, to murder the king. The wounded person felt feelings. He said, I quote, forgive me, unquote. But the words spoken by that wounded person, and that person spoke in a very weak voice because the blood was coming out of his body. He was in pain. The wounded person revealed his identity to the king. The wounded person promised that he would serve the king as his servant throughout his life. That was very happy. And he made peace with his enemy so easily and promised him to help. The king approached to the hermit and wanted to know the answer of three questions in the next morning. As usual, the hermit was busy in his work. The hermit astonished the king by saying that he has given the answer of the three questions. The king could not realize in what manner the hermit has given the answer of his three questions. The answer of the hermit was that, I quote, so the most important time was when you were digging the beds, and I was the most important man at that time, and to do me good was your important business. Important at that time in the beginning, the hermit said that he was the important person, that was the important time, and to help the hermit was the important work for the king. Afterward, I quote, afterwards, when that man ran to us, the most important time was when you were attending to him. He would have died without making truce. So you are the most important person to the king at that time. The hermit further said, I quote, remember then, there is only one time that is the most important, that is now, unquote. It is the only time that one has power. The most necessary person is that with whom you are. See in what manner the hermit replied to the problem of the king. The king raised the three questions, and the hermit made the king realize that the most important time is now, when you can do something, when you are in power. And the most important persons are those with whom you are. And the most important work is to do good work, to do service to the humanity. That is the most important work. The most important affair is to do good. This is the only purpose for which we are sent here, for which we are sent here on this earth. The hermit gave this moral of this story, that the most important time is the present. The most important person is the person with whom you are. And the most important thing is to do good for fellow beings. It is a great solution of the problems of the king. See in what manner the writer gives this solution of these three questions. Actually, Leo Tolstoy was a great spiritual person, thinker, philosopher. He realized the problems of life and he presented certain solutions of life. In that manner, he was a great thinker, great philosopher. Thanks.